Welcome to the home of contagious encouragement, Keep the Faith. I'm Donna Cruz.
And I'm Keith Stevens. In this Valentine's season, who better to join us than our good friend Jackie Dorman? Her Married in 12 Months or Less challenge has become a movement, helping thousands of single women find love. And now she shares her principles in her new book, Married in 12 Months or Less. Welcome to Keep the Faith.
It is great to be back with you celebrating true lasting love today. Married in 12 Months or Less isn't some catchy gimmick. It's about doing the hard work, or what I call heart work, so that you're the kind of person that's ready for love when it comes. And I really believe that it will come. So I hope you're ready to be encouraged as we share together on Keep the Faith today with songs and stories that sound like this.
Lead me with strong hands, stand up when I can.
That's one thing everybody agrees on. You know, Christian, atheist, Republican, Democrat, everybody believes that our society is in somewhat of a decline. But we can also look back a few decades ago, and we realized there was a generation of people, and that's the best we ever were.
Whatever it is, quality time makes me feel loved, and people need to find out, what's my language? How do I receive love the best? Because that is the way that you're going to need someone to show you love in order for you to feel it.
Love moves first.
What does love look like to you? Jackie Dorman shares from her own life next on Keep the Faith.
Have you ever met those who keep humming when the song's through? It's like they're living life to a whole different tune. And have you ever met those that keep hoping when it's hopeless? It's like so when you're standing in the rain again, you might as well be dancing. Why? 'Cause there ain't no storm that can change how this is. So next time when you feel blue, don't let that smile leave you. Why? 'Cause you have every reason just to sing. So the back row is your glide. 'Cause walking just won't do dance. You don't have to know how. Ever since grace got you left, till your whole side's hurt and smile, like you just got away with something. Why? 'Cause you just got away with something. Ever since grace got you. Ever since grace got you. Grace got you.
hope the songs and stories you hear today can help you begin a new story filled with contagious encouragement. This is Keep the Faith.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory.
Listening to Keep the Faith.
Hey, I'm Keith Stevens. Love is a language we all speak, but there are all kinds of different dialects, and even with the people you're closest to, you may not be understanding each other. Jackie Dorman is our matchmaking friend and author of the new book, Married in 12 Months or Less. She shares about how true love is sometimes found out of the traditional box.
You know, we put so much emphasis on this holiday, and my husband's never traditionally been that great at holidays. Whether it's anniversaries or Valentine's Day, birthdays, but what he really is good at is just showing me that he loves me all year long. One of my love languages is just quality time. And so that quality time that makes me feel loved, David's really good about showing that to me, whether it's watching a chick flick that he really doesn't want to watch just so that he can sit next to me on the couch and we can cuddle up, or anytime I have to go anywhere, people make fun of me. They're like, "Do you ever drive yourself?" I'm like, "No," because he just drives me around and then he waits in the car for me when I run in because I hate to park, and I can just come out and get in the car like I'm some kind of celebrity, right? Whatever it is, quality time makes me feel loved. And people need to find out, what's my language? How do I receive love the best? Because that is the way that you're going to need someone to show you love in order for you to feel it.
This is the story of a runaway with no way home and no way out. I threw the best of me away. I had my chance. It's too late now. Too far gone and too ashamed to think that you'd still know my name. But love refused to let my story end that way. You didn't wait for me to find my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running. Relentless grace would chase this rebel down, crawl into this prisoner's cage, take my hand and pull me out. You knew I couldn't make the change, so you became the change in me. And now I live to tell the story of the God who rescues. You didn't wait for me. Found my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running after me when anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love moved from the throne to the manger, from the manger to the grave. Your cross. Cross is the proof that love made the first move. You didn't wait for me to find my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running.
I think what distinguishes the best friends from even just good friends is this. They know every part. They know every part of me that's possible to know. They know my dark side. They know my weaknesses. They know my challenges. They know my sins. They know my brokenness. They know my family of origin. They know my career. And when you've got a few people like that there are no secrets from, you have just hit the gold mine.
Contagious encouragement on Keep the Faith.
I'm Jackie Dorman, the author of Married in 12 Months or Less. There are all kinds of real-life love stories to inspire you in this season, not only at lovestories.com, but also right here on Keep the Faith. So I can't wait to hear what's next.
Today's successes are built on the backs of yesterday's wisdom. That's especially true when it comes to the love stories between you and your kids. Andy Andrews is coming up.
Good God Almighty,
the times I've called your name some broken night, and you showed up and patched me up like you do every time. I get amnesia, I forget that you keep coming around. Yeah, ain't no way you ever let me down. Good God Almighty, I hope you find me praising your name no matter what comes, 'cause I know where I'd be without your mercy. So I keep praising your name at the top of my lungs. Tell me, is he good?
He's good.
Tell me, is he
God?
You say your love goes on forever, that your mercy never stops. So why would I assume you'll be somebody that you're not? Like sun in the morning, I know you're gonna be there every day. So what on earth could make me be afraid? Good God Almighty,
I'm Danny Gokey, and this is the home of contagious encouragement. Keep the faith.
Can't escape disappointment, can't avoid the delay, but I don't have to make feeling down and defeated the place that I stay. Gonna rise to the moment, gonna speak to the waves, gonna push back the doubt that keeps dragging me down when I can't find a way.
Walk by after my faith. I was standing fast.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
I'm Brandy Lene. A child can feel like a gift you open, and you know that gift is extremely special. But if you're honest, you don't really know what to do with it sometimes. Our friend Andy Andrews is a regular contributor here on Keep the Faith. He's been on the New York Times best-selling books list many times, including with titles like The Traveler's Gift and The Bottom of the Pool.
I really believe that parenting is the fulcrum that our society tilts upon. I have come to believe that more and more fully over the past couple of years. I work with teams at all levels, and I see, wow, it's parenting issues. I'll go in for some company, and there will be this division that's having these huge challenges, and I'm supposed to help. And I sit down this 46-year-old person, and within 10 minutes, I go, wow, all this could have been handled when he was 8, right? Because it's parenting. And I look at our entire society. In our entire society, we can track a decline. I mean, we all know that. That's one thing everybody agrees on. You know, Christian, atheist, Republican, Democrat, everybody believes that our society is in somewhat of a decline. But we can also look back a few decades ago and we realize there was a generation of people, and that's the best we ever were. We can track our rise to them and our decline afterwards. We look at those people and we say, man, those people sacrificed more, they became more, they produced more, they learned more, they taught more. We even have a name for them, right? We call them the greatest generation. But here's something very curious. I don't really believe they were the greatest generation. I'm gonna give that tag to their parents. Because with the parents and the grandparents and the teachers, by what standard did those people raise an entire generation of people that we look back 70 years and still say, that's the best we ever were? What did they do? What did they require? What did they understand? What did they teach? How did they explain it? Because their methods produced the best. And I think we can still do that today.
There's a reason Andy Andrews is one of the most sought-out motivational speakers in the country. Hear why when you check out his conversation with us on CIA, Contagious Influencers of America, the free podcast from the producers of Keep the Faith. Find it at KeepTheFaith.com or wherever you get your podcasts.
I look around and see my wonderful life, almost perfect. From the outside, in picture frames, I see my beautiful wife, always smiling, but on the inside, oh, I can hear her saying, lead me with strong hands, stay. Of your life, I know we
there is a power that is unleashed when you say, you know what, no matter what, I'm going to be all in. And this one husband, he put it this way. He said, it's what happens when you say, we are going to lock ourselves in this marriage and throw away the key. Everything changed when they realized, you know what, we got to get rid of the separate bank accounts. We've got to stop keeping secrets. We've got to recognize we are in this marriage for a lifetime. So we better figure out how to make this work.
Next on Keep the Faith, a woman is praying for the future husband she hasn't even met yet. Did it make a difference?
And listen, remember part of my story, I wasn't even a Christian yet. So there was things that I absolutely could have been doing and had a clear conscience about that for some reason, even in the midst of having those opportunities, I just didn't.
In the dark and all alone, growing comfortable. Are you too scared to move and walk out of this tomb? Buried underneath the lies that you believed. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Rise up, rise up,
oh.
Rise up,
out from the grave like Lazarus. When he said your name, your veins was more than blood, it's a kind of love that washes sin away. Now the door is open wide and the stone's been rolled aside. The old is gone, the light has come. So come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're
Dorman, sharing contagious encouragement on Keep the Faith.
Head down as I punch this clock, the hours roll, they never stop, and I can't ever seem to get ahead. Always trying to do what's right, straight and narrow's getting tight, don't know how much longer I can stand.
And I'm wondering, yeah, I'm wondering, where's my promised land? Out here on this desert road, it's hot as fire, but I've grown cold. Circling like a plane that never lands. And even though the questions change, the answers always stay the same. Maybe someday I will understand. So I'm wondering, got me wondering, where's my promised land? Yeah, I'm wondering, still I'm wondering, where's my promised land? I've run this earth for many years. If there's one thing I know, there's nowhere on this side of heaven where streets are made of gold. I've long laid down my grand illusions, looking toward the day that I'll be home. I won't give up on this race. Broken, but I still have faith that this old life is all part of a plan. And I can feel it in my soul. One day I'll stand before the throne with nothing left but hope in these two hands. Through all these seasons, I'm still believing you're my promised land.
Listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Donna Cruz. There are all kinds of ingredients that make a relationship work, but you don't read about some of them in greeting cards. Michael Jr. is a comedian who loves to make people laugh.
My wife wanted to go to the prenatal classes, right? And I'm like, why I gotta go to class? You're pregnant, I pass. You know what I'm saying? I could teach a class or something. I don't know what you want me to do, but I went to the class because I love my wife, right? And I'm afraid that they're gonna play the video. I don't want to watch the video. I'm looking for Bible verses against the video.
When it comes to Michael and his wife, the power that has been behind their marriage is prayer.
My wife is so phenomenal. She actually wrote a book about how we met, technically. The book is called Before He Finds You, and it kind of details how she was praying for me and the things that she was doing to prepare herself to be a wife even before we even met. It's pretty amazing. Like, she was praying, and listen, remember part of my story, I wasn't even a Christian yet. So there was things that I absolutely could have been doing and had a clear conscience about that for some reason, even in the midst of having those opportunities, I just didn't. I either lost a taste for it or just wasn't interested. And we look back at it, and it's because my wife was praying. It's pretty phenomenal. And when we got married, I was a single dad of three, which is a whole nother comedy routine. So she is phenomenally, tremendously amazing, a little past amazing. So the book, for the ladies listening, because I know they're like, ooh, what's the name of it again? It's called Before He Finds You.
When I think about where I would have been without you, I'm so glad it's a place I never have to be. Even if I tried, I couldn't count the ways. Not enough for words for me to ever say just how good you are to me. Hey, how could I hide this joy inside of me? Amazing grace, oh Lord, how can it be?
singing like, amen. For words for me to ever say, just how good you are to me. Yeah. How could I hide this joy inside of me? Amazing grace, oh Lord, I can't it be? Every day of my life, I want the world to see. I can't get over what you've done for me. You got me singing like, amen. What you've done for me, that's why I gotta sing. I can't get over what you've done for me, that's why I gotta sing. Every mountain, every valley, ever since the day you found me, I can't get over what you've done for me, that's why I gotta sing. Amen. Oh. How could I hide this joy inside of me?
I don't see how I can do all this. I don't see how I can be this kind of loving person on my own. And he's, you know, he's like saying, well, that's the point. I want you to depend on me. You need my love in you. There are ways that I show my love to you that you're not acknowledging, not seeing, not understanding. And he says, you have to receive my love. And then you have to express your love to me, because when we express our love to him, he pours himself into us. And that's how he fills us with his love, so that we can love others the way he wants us to.
But your love, the only thing that matters is your love, all I ever needed.
This is Keep the Faith.
I'm Dee Rodriguez on Keep the Faith with an encouraging thought from Katherine Hepburn. Love has nothing to do with what you're expecting to get, only what you're expecting to give, which is everything.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice at the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, oh, he's a chain breaker. Believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, so-
to testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm author and matchmaker Jackie Dorman. I talk with people a lot about relationship principles at lovestories.com. But things really come to life when I share a story. I suspect the same is true for you. Your story of hope and love could impact someone else today. Just call 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
The first boyfriend I ever had and I we dated on and off for about 4 years. He was a bit of a bad boy, roughneck, and we broke up for the last time when I was about 18 years old. And 25 years later, I ran into an old friend of ours. They told me he was in prison. So I wrote him a letter, and then he called me, and the first thing he said to me was, I need you to know that I've turned my life over to God. I don't do any of those things anymore, and I never will again. And he got out of prison last June. We got married, and then 3 weeks later, he was diagnosed with bone marrow cancer, and he died this past July. So we only got a year together. But what he didn't know when I first spoke to him was that my mother had passed away 5 years earlier, and I had just really gotten away from God. And I know without a doubt that God used him as a vessel to bring me back to my faith.
I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. There's empty praise. And treasures that fade are never enough. Then you came along.